Someone who should be avoided, Mr. Waldron, there.
Excrement.
And he is contaminating your standing in the community. And if you have any common sense to think on it, you should reflect that he is bringing down your standing and reputation in the world. Because it'll all come out in time. But no, any objective observer would see his behavior on that bridge was an attempt. It was a domination of women. That's what he was all about there. He was going to dominate this woman and bring her down. Well, let's know. There's been at least 200 years. Other ladies can talk here of this fight for freedom, for women's liberation, to have a full and free life. And that's what he came down. That was oozing out of him. As with any objective fact finder, look at that. He was going to break Gemma Doherty. What a phantom myth. Never happened. A legend. And once that seeps through to the people of Ireland, that filthy concept of domination. And I'd say to you, every one of you has either a wife or a girlfriend. And I don't know. You, I'd say, have little regard for your wives or girlfriends, if you stand 15 minutes near that guy.
Yeah.
So that's what I'd reflect on. I reflect on, because he attacked womanhood. He attacked freedom. So that's what you think. If you have any regard for them and their free, expansive life ahead, or stay away from that guy. Don't associate him. Send them to Coventry. Ostracism. I'm afraid to be on the same planet as them. I finally end up with saying this. Early on in this, we're talking about masks now. In this, Farrakhan made crisis, New World Order made crisis, it became very clear early that there was an alternative to locking down an economy. And that was brought forward by people like the German doctors and Dr. René Lacour in Canada and our own Dolores Cahill. And they basically said, we'll go into it briefly, that you didn't need to lock down a country. You didn't need to do social distancing or the mask wearing. You could protect our elderly, which the nursing homes, which Radcliffe didn't do. But you could do that and keep your buoyant economy. And what I would say to you is this. You have collaborated in destroying this economy. This wearing of masks and hounding people to wear masks and social distancing, that's driving every nearly business out of existence. Well, that in the long run is destroying your children.
That's right.
You are instrumental in destroying your own children and grandchildren.
And
so their economy is shattered. So when you've got a 21-year-old son and he's going for a job, before this, in November 2019, there was only 7 going for the job. Now there's 77. And there's no hiding from that. That's going to all come out. That you, instead of being with the people, we know it's difficult, you've taken an oath, but there comes a time, every person.